The following video contains content and language that may be inappropriate for younger audiences. Viewer discretion is advised. Hello guys, Zul'jin here, and welcome back to another episode of Witcher the Wild Hunt, as the horse tells the people in the camera hi. Last time we left off, guys, we had did a few of the points of interest and a little side quest involving the alchemist, and also learned a little bit about alchemy. And now I'm going to proceed with the Beast of the White Orchard quest a little bit further now that I'm level 2. And I think I should go in here and talk to the hunters.
Anyone home?
Must be out hunting.
Okay, so it looks like I'm going to have to look for signs of where they went. Some tracks here. The tracks lead. Examine.
Trail's fresh. His love just left home.
Okay, and now I have to go to this area. Looks like I have something to examine here. Or just a little bit further in. Also have to keep an eye on my map for monsters. Looks like there's something up ahead. There's Mislav.
You, Mislav?
Hear that?
Mm-hmm. Wolves.
Wolves? No. Wild dogs.
Yes. More dangerous than wolves.
Really? Where'd you find the Nilfgaardians' bodies?
I'm hunting bigger game. The Nilfgaardians the Griffin killed. Where'd you find them?
Ah, I see. You a witcher. That monster slayer they's talking about in the village.
Mm-hmm.
I'll show you, sure, but I gotta kill those mutts before they hurt someone. Will you help? That is, if you don't mind blunting your silver blades on them.
Why not?
Sure, Griffin's not going anywhere.
No, dogs might, though, so step careful now. Come on.
Okay.
These dogs been a problem for a while now?
Since the war started. Soldier on the march, he'll stop to rape a woman, strangle her, kill her man for a chuckle, even butcher a cow.
Wow.
But a dog, a kick in passing, no more. So these stray mutts form packs. They're gaunt, guts stuck to their spines, covered in scabies, but they just won't die, because they're clever. More so than foxes, and they hate men something fierce.
Well,
too late.
I'm sure they hate
Attacked
witches too.
Another one.
Okay, he's gonna back me up, it looks like. Yeah, lure him here. Good shot, bud.
Damn your hobby.
Ooh. Dang, took a little lick. Let's eat a baked potato, shall we? Okay. Seems pretty good.
Dieter.
You know him?
We served at the Lord's Manor together, where the Black Army's encamped now. He was a stable hand, I was the Lord's Hunter. But that was before... well, a long time ago.
The Nilfgaardians, where'd you find them?
Sorry. Hope you weren't close.
No. Not at all.
So... can you show me where you found the Nilfgaardians? Griffin, know anything about it?
Oh, not much. It's not my kind of game.
You're his kind, though. Survival instincts alone ought to make you care.
I walk silent through the woods. No Griffin can hear me nor spy me.
I guess, those are mighty big words, buddy. I found you. Of course I'm a witcher, not a Griffin. Where are you taking me, man? Looks like back to the road some.
T'was here. One lay there, by the stump, headless. The other hung from a branch, guts splayed, stretching down to...
yeah, enough details,
watch out for yourself now.
I'll be fine.
I'll be fine. Not the first Griffin I've dealt with. Not likely to be the last, either.
Hope you're right. Good hunting now.
Okay. So, examine.
Nilfgaardians were celebrating. Griffin interrupted them.
I need to get as much info as I can in this area. Looks like I could scan that. I hear dogs around too.
Ground's black, saturated with blood.
What else can I scan around here? Anything in the tree? No. How about here? Okay, some tracks here.
These prints are older and deeper, heavily armored. Nilfgaardians, probably.
There's a sign up here I have to grab for fast travel. More tracks. Seems like they lead back into this area. Hold on. Broken bridge there. I should probably go across. Can I see anything inside the... Ah, there's some stuff down there. Some lootables. Amateur's armor repair kit. Cool, I'll take that. And linen. Definitely. Okay, what else can I see? Doesn't look like anything right off. Maybe I'll just need to jump up here. There we go. Are those wolves, maybe? Are those dogs? Yeah, there's something over there. Wolves. Gorgs. Nice. Wolf's liver. Okay, let's go back to that area. I don't want to get too far off the beaten path here. Alright. Let's make the perimeter. There we go. Some tracks there. Leading... Where'd they come from? I'm hearing more dogs. It looks like that trail starts here and goes this way. I'm pretty sure I already checked this though, right? Yeah, over the bridge. Oh, wrong button. Alright, now I'm in the totally wrong area. Need to go back past the bridge here. And I missed. Okay. This is where I was a second ago. Now it kind of updated here. Checking the entire perimeter. I don't know why I can't examine this. See some more wolves over there. I gotta be careful. Maybe up here? Tracks are here. Alright. Up here again, maybe? Yep. More tracks. Leading up to... Might as well take this while I'm here. I didn't want to chop it. Just grab the plant, man. Thank you. Okay, and... Let's see here. Looks like I might have to go up. Oh, grabbing ledges. I didn't mean to do that. Okay, let's try that again. Grabbing ledges, jump over large gaps during a leap to grab onto the edge. Aha, got it. Sweet. Okay, witch's senses, there's the track. And Looks like they kind of end there. What is that? Why can't I harvest this? It doesn't give me any ability to grab that. See what I mean? Nothing to interact with, although I can see
Griffin's
it.
Nest.
Aha!
What remains of it, at least.
Okay. We found it.
Corpse is a couple of weeks old. Still alive when the Griffin brought him here. Took a long time dying.
Yeah. Huh. A dead Griffin.
Female. Larvae and her wounds have already hatched. Been dead at least a week. Other Griffin must be a male.
Determine age.
Beak tips worn. Gray hairs in the coat. 10-12 years old. Griffins pair off for life when young. Male must be about the same age.
Determine type.
Thick shaft, dense barbs. A royal griffin.
And examine wounds.
Deep cuts over the whole body. Not a drop of blood on the beak or claws. Didn't defend herself. Crept up on her while she slept.
Step away.
Explains why the male I ran into was so aggressive. Hunted the Nilfgaardians down here in the forest first, then started prowling the area.
So it's a vengeance thing. Level 3. Nice. Okay, so I got points available. Never underestimate your opponent. The rule is that the core of Witch's code, and for good reason, proper preparation has saved many lives, many a witch's life. It's likewise worth your while to brew potions, concoct oils, or visit craftsmen before engaging in combat. If you expect to battle a strong opponent, you might want to complete some side quests before attacking. Well, we've been doing that, so that's good. This will allow you to gain experience and develop your character, giving you a better chance in the fight. Okay, so let's go to character and see what we can improve here. We can bring up the stat again to grab more quick attacks, and I'm still using those very heavily. So I think that is probably a very, very good good deal. Now, I can press the right button here and go to different... Oh, no, that's meditation. Left button. And that meditation can be used to heal. It just passes through time. I was thinking points available in branch. Let's see here. So, aha, I see. So there's different branches altogether. That's something that I failed to look at earlier, which I didn't waste any because muscle memory is a really good skill from what I can see. Let's see, signs. Now, these are different signs, I guess. Far-reaching or increases. Ah, okay, so you can improve melt armor. Holy cow. You can improve the different things you have. Sustained glyph sign. Number of alternative mode charges, 2. Number of standard mode traps. I guess that's, okay, I see now. Axie sign. Charm opponent. Queen sign. Protective shield. That's the magic trap. Igni sign. A directed fiery blast. Okay, so melt armor is the next one. I really like that, but let me go into crafting a little bit and see. Brewing increases potion overdose threshold. Oh, wow. Poisoned blades, steady aim for bomb creation, acquired tolerance. Okay, let's move on to possibly, what is this? Sun and stars during the next day. General. Okay, these are like passives. During the next day, vitality regenerates by an additional 10 points per second when not in combat. At night, stamina regenerates. Oh, that's pretty cool. Survival instinct, increase maximum vitality by 500. Wow. That seems huge, right? Cat's cool techniques. Each piece of light armor increases critical hit damage by 25% and fast attack damage by 5%. Now, that's a good skill, too. Griffin's cool techniques. Each piece of medium armor, okay, I see. So these are like the passives, and this is something that I haven't learned yet. Okay, so, guys, I really think that this survival instinct is going to be my best bet, so I'm going to select that. Do I have any points available? Points in branch. Let's see here. Acquire ability. 500 vitality. I think that was a great spend myself. Okay, so I don't have any points left, but I do have some Enhanced weapons left available. I guess I should take, let's see, world map. There is a point of interest here I should probably explore. So I think I'm gonna do that. Oh, and I saw some red on the map there. I have to be real careful here. Still have a little bit of enhanced weapons.
Magic. Uh-oh. A place of power.
I felt my controller vibrating a little bit too. Hold to draw. Wow, I gained an ability point from that? That's great. Okay. Oh man, I'm happy about that. Okay, let's take a look. Do I need to... Wait. Do I need to equip that other skill that I had before? I don't think so because it's a passive, but... No, I do have to do it. Okay, survival instinct. So that increases my... Okay, I see now. So I think my best bet here, instead of getting new abilities, is to enhance the abilities that I already have. I think I'm going to go ahead and increase muscle memory again. Yeah, that seemed like a good idea. Or can I do that? Upgrade ability? Yes. Okay, improved ability. How many points do I have left? Points in branch. Points available, 0. Okay. So we did good. Well, that was awesome. Quinsine intensity increased. What is Quinsine again? Let's see. Quin is... Protective Shield. Uh-huh. Deals fire damage. That's Igni. Quin. Huh. That's pretty useful. Okay. Well, that was definitely a great spot to hit. Okay, so I'm guessing that we should probably hit this one before we get too far away as well. And that one's going to be a little bit to the west here. So let's run over to that. My health is full. That's good. 500 vitality, man. That's a rock and roll thing. Okay.
Don't let him catch his breath!
Ha-ha!
Shit.
Burn! Yeah, witchcraft. You got that right. Ha! Lay down, boys! Wow, okay, the leader's left. Oh, man, the fire. Gotta love
perish.
It. Perish? Yeah, how about you perish? Burn. Oh! Woo! Wow! Oh man, that felt good. Fried meat? Don't mind if I do. Thanks for dinner. Wow, man. That was intense. Fatality. Okay, got some butter. Alchemist powder. Vials. A bunch of stuff. Torn out page. Oh, what was that? I guess it's a new quest item of some sort. And... loot this, some silver. I think that's probably it. Let me, there's something I could get here as well. Some more water, and that Everlance is like a vitality restore. Anything over here that I should look at? Doesn't look like it. There's some lootable stuff right here. Gotta go on the opposite side there. Vials, old bear hides, alchemist powder. Okay, I think that's almost everything here. Oh, it looks like I have to go to this side too. Loot, water. Water's good. And it looks like that's about it. Not bad at all. Okay, I do see that movement down there, but I think I'm just going to avoid it for now and progress a little bit. Collect some plants along the way. Try to keep these alchemy ingredients up. That way when I run into something that I need, like for a quest or something of that nature, I have it. Or I have at least partial. Gives me a little bit more exposure to what the crafting's all about. By the way, for those of you who are commenting and you wonder why I might not respond to your comments or at least talk about them in the next videos when they're relevant, I'm doing backlog videos at this point, so sometimes I might be two or three days ahead in episodes. Just FYI. Ouch! Oh, that was a crit! Oh no! Load most recent save. Where does that put us? Oh please, man. How bad was this? Okay, it could have been worse. I'm gonna roughly run over to the area that we just finished up. Alright you guys, I just finished off getting my skill points again, and I did kill that wolf on the way back. Just that I was ready for it again, and now we're close to the little spot on the map that is the next quest spot for, or the waypoint for Beast of the White Orchard. So let's go ahead on in. And it looks like it's somewhere out in the water, so I might have to do some swimming here. Swimming speed, hold A to swim swiftly. Uh-oh. Is there fish of some sort here? I see some red arrows on the map. I'm using the Witcher sign here. Oh, I see. Is there a way to dive? Yeah, let's dive. Looks like there's a couple of things that we can look at. I got a little bit of breath here. What exactly are those things here? Can I loot that? Oh, okay. Oh, I got something. Gotta watch my breath here. Buckthorn. Got it. That was the spot. Okay. So I need to go to surface now. Wow.
And all I could. Should talk to Vesemir.
Okay. So I got the buckthorn. That's what I needed to do. And now I gotta go talk to Vesemir again. Let's see. Where is he at in relation to where I am? How hard can it be to swim in all that armor, huh? Okay, so Vesemir is going to be right at the tavern. Very good. I'm going to just call a little roach over. Coming, buddy. I'm coming, buddy. Okay. Oh, almost fell off the edge there. Roach, watch your step, buddy. Watch your step there, buddy. Another thing I'm going to do is save. Because I think that's I think that's important. I keep forgetting to do that. All right. Good. Now, if something crazy happens, we'll know that we won't lose much progress. At least not the progress I was really intending on not doing a third time. Okay. Let's sneak behind this house here.
Kings do the fighting.
Oh, maybe that wasn't a good idea. Hey, piggy. Alright, this leaves us where... Oh, okay, I'm right behind the tavern here. This is good.
Goidemar, will you raise a glass with me?
It's Dervan now. D-E-R-V-A-N, not Goidemar.
Looking for trouble.
I'm sorry.
Whose field is that, the other side of the river?
Uh-huh, he's inside.
Boy in Climax.
Witcher's good lad, just Master Witcher. Drinking.
Though he.
Yes, yes. This boy.
Oh wait.
Venture out to inspect his grain anytime soon.
What for? Harvest is a long way off yet.
Oh, now I got to talk to Vesemir.
Yes.
My bad.
What is it, Wolf?
I've accepted a contract for the Griffin.
Got good news and bad news. Good news first. Captain of a Nilfgaardian garrison knows where Yennefer went.
And the bad's that we have to kill the Griffin for him.
Yeah.
What else could he want from two witchers? Go on. Tell me what you know.
Griffin's abandoned its lair. Gotta make a lure, set a trap.
And how's that going?
Got some information about the Griffin. Got the buckthorn already.
Got the buckthorn.
Ought to work like a charm. Powerful scent.
More like stench.
City boy. Rotting meat, manure, piss. Standard smells of the countryside. Remember Tredegor? Hunting that Zoogle in the trash heap? You spent half the next day bathing, scrubbing yourself.
How can I forget? You ever gonna stop bringing that up?
Alright. Got some information about the group.
Learned some things. It's a male. Had its nest in the Vulpine Woods. The Nilfgaardians burned the woods down, killed its mate, smashed their eggs. Thought they'd fixed things.
It's always the same. Instead of sending for a professional, they try to do it themselves, only end up making matters worse.
Yep.
Fine. If everything's ready, say the word and we'll get to work.
I'm ready. Time to set the trap.
I'm ready. No point in waiting. Let's find a good spot to ambush it.
Picked one out already, other side of the stream. There's fields and a grove. Plenty of room and far enough so no one will get in our way.
Good. Meet you there.
Okay. So to prepare for the fight by griffing by brewing the Thunderbolt Potion. Okay, we'll have to brew the Thunderbolt Potion. And it looks like to create an item you'll need the right ingredients. Yes, I know all about this already. Let's see, Thunderbolt. We got what I need, I guess. We needed some Dwarven Spirits, some Cortinerus, and some Ingreta Embryo, whatever. Okay, so we brewed the Thunderbolt. In order to use an item during gameplay, you must first equip it in the inventory panel. Equipping items, use the left button and right button to select the inventory panel. Oh, I can't make that again. No, I already have the item. Okay. Potion. You have a Witcher potion, but in order to use it, you must first equip it. Okay, potions, navigate to the usable items. Navigate the usable items tab. Oh, no, that's not what I wanted to do. Plus 21, yeah. Okay. Amateur's armor repair kit, no. Usable items. Is that what we need to do? Right here? Consumables. Trophy. Horse binders. Usable, I guess, pockets? Bombs. Ah, usable items. Okay, I got you. Jeez, man. And where is that potion I just made? Toniol, cat, swallow. Baked apples. And use the L to select Thunderbolt and choose it. Where is the potion of Thunderbolt? Apple juice. Thunderbolt. There we go. And we'll select it in... I guess we'll put it where the water is. There we go. Now you can use this potion during gameplay. Yeah, we know that. Okay. Okay, so got it. Let's get on Roach.
Run, Roach.
Or just walk. Alright, so let's see on the world map where we go. So it looks like we have to go right behind this field here. We'll take a left at the first fork. And he should just be able to take a left right here. And go across the way. This looks like the site across this river here. Okay.
Slower.
This is going to be the spot, but that is going to have to wait till next episode, you guys. Next time we come back, the battle with the Griffin. Thank you guys so much for watching. As always, this is Zul'jin signing off, and we'll see you next time.